We are back with X-Ray's third game. He's 1-1. I haven't recorded any of his games live. Yeah, he's on Team Germany. And the Thorn, I think he only played one game so far, and I think he got hexed a bit. I think he's 0-1. He's on Team Europe, if I'm not mistaken. So, X-Ray about Webs. So this is pretty much the standard NJMP Webs team. He might have changed the set here and there. I think the Zagat is like Double Dance with Dragon Dance and Coil. So looking at the Thorns team, either the Tornadus or the Magearna is going to be Assault Vest. The Garchomp has to be Scarf, so I think it's it might be Scarf Rocks Mew. Scarf Rocks Garchomp is what I meant to say. It might be Scarf Rocks Garchomp and Rocks. Default Mew, obviously, for the Zard. But yeah, he does just go for the safe taunt, turn 1. So if X-Ray had Magic Code, that could have been a 50-50. Because I know some Smeagols run Magic Code to bounce taunt back. So this is pretty much confirms that this is live up Tornadus, because he's not, like, he's obviously not AV if he has taunt, so that makes me think that he's Assault Vest Magearna, Z-Move Tapu Bulu. And this Hurricane does a lot, because Bishop is not that bulky and it's live up Hurricane, like. I'm not sure if Sucker Punch would kill this. But yeah, I think Bishop take damage is a bit annoying, because like if Bishop getting weakened is annoying because she gets up Heather with Smeagol later on the Magearna or something, that would kind of force the defog, and Bishop would get a Define from that, but now it's already weakened. I mean, Mew obviously outspeeds most Bishop variants. Like, people should run enough speed on Mew to Will-O-Wisp Bisharp. He does just go for superpower. Wow. I thought why did he not go for Sucker? I mean, he probably predicted the switch, but like, maybe the Thorn knew he could live a Sucker Punch. Yeah, I don't see how X-Ray can win this one. Like, the Tornadus is still in, so he obviously can't go back to Smeagol unless he predicts correct and goes for Magic Code on a taunt. Z-Conversion Porygon is like a small threat, but it's not gonna win. Pretty sure if it's that wide, it still takes any hit from Porygon, unless it's electric, and if it's electric Porygon, it gets revenged by Earthquake from Scarf Jump. Magearna also takes a hit from AV to bring it in range from either Zard or Garchomp, I assume. Like with a Floricane, unless the Porygon has Recover. So he's gonna try to set up with his Zygarde. I don't know if he will taunt predicting the setup move here. He just goes hard on the top of Bulu. And these 1000 arrows, and this is absolutely nothing, because it's not banded. Oh, Zamrock said if X-Ray plays it right, it's over. Thought it was over for the for X-Ray. I mean, Pinsir can be a huge threat. The thing is, Tornadus doesn't get affected even if Webs go up, because it's in the air. So X-Ray is either gonna go into Pinsir here, Why did he not go to pincer? So he's gonna try to set up on this. Okay, like if he coiled hard on the switch, it would have been nice. But yeah, this is an SD, so like, if he has Iron Tail, that would be cool. But I assume his last move is either Outrage or E-Speed. But yeah, if he calls again, he lives. The Bulu might have Z move. Yeah. If the Bulu Z moves here, I don't. Like, if he has Woodhammer, Z Woodhammer, this probably dies. But I assume it's gonna be not Z Woodhammer. I assume it's gonna be Z Superpower. Just Horn Leeches, yeah. Oh, it is Citrus Berry. For some reason, I thought it was Leftovers, but that was just the grass terrain health that he got back. So it's just a standard NGNP set, okay. Still Citrus. I don't know if NGNP like says like there's a Mew. I think he's talking about that he should have just gone to Mew and Will-O-Wisp this before it gets out of hand. Because this doesn't run substitutes, like. Yeah, if he goes Mew, webs go up. Probably. Do they go up? He just went for T arrows. But this is not going to hit KO because he healed so much back. Couldn't he have coiled again there? I'm not really sure. This game is so weird. He does have E-Speed. So if he coiled again, I don't know if E-Speed would have killed this. Probably not with all the health that it got back from the Horn Leech. Yeah, 2 E-Speeds, my E-Speed instead of... No, 2 E-Speeds wouldn't have killed, yeah, I don't think so. So now he goes Pinsir or... Yeah, Pinsir. He goes Smeargle. So he wants up his Hazards first. But the thing is, like I said, Torn is in the air, so doesn't care about webs, it only cares about rocks. He has taunt on everything. Is he really trying to C-team webs? C-team. Like, how does X-Ray win this? He doesn't, right? Rocks are nice for the Zard, obviously, and for the Tornadus. We miss a Stone Age, that hurts. That would have killed. He was at plus 2. Pretty sure that would have killed. And that was a nice play from the Stone and expert disconnect. I think he also disconnected a few times earlier. Man, feels bad for Team Germany. Like, not that he disconnected. He obviously just got Hex in his favor, but like, the Stone is kind of destroying him. Turn this shit on. The timer. I mean, he's forced to attack the Tapu Bulu because he don't want to take a Stone Edge. Yeah, Mew. I don't think Mew can take 2 return off a station. It rocks up unless it's unless it runs more Fistef than the standard set. The standard set runs some Spidef. So it can also kind of check Tapu Koko, stuff like that. So he does just sack off the Tapu Bulu. And the question is, do you go into Stone Edge Garchomp here, or do you go into Muted Defog? He goes into Tornadus, which is the other option that he had, because going Zard doesn't make any sense, because Zard would die to return after Rocks. And Megina is still nice to keep healthy for the Porygon later on. Yeah, I can see that. But if Porygon is recover Z conversion, I think it beats Meginna one on one. And he dodges Hurricane. So is he gonna predict? Is he just gonna attack again, or is he gonna taunt? Because I can see X-Ray going for Magic Code, predicting the taunt. If he has, so he's gonna have Rocks, Webs, a Spore, and then it's either Magic, either it's Taunt Smeagol or it's Magic Code, right? Stone Edge missed on Prince, but it connected with X-Ray because he disconnected. He has Magic Code, but he, the Sun is just, oh my lord, getting every play correct. Oh boy. I think he predicted the Magic Code. Yeah, that was a nice play. So most dead, yeah, he doesn't have U-turn. I was about to say most of them don't carry U-turn, but he already showed his entire moveset. He just went for knockoff twice to not, like, Super Power doesn't kill because he has Sash anyway, and like you obviously don't want to miss a Hurricane again. So he's gonna taunt, predicting SD. Wow, this man is unstoppable. I'm guessing that X-Ray predicted like the Meginna or something, so he wanted to SD up to more damage, do more damage to that. So it's Life Orb Mimikyu. It's obviously like Z move on Porygon, so this is Life Orb, yeah. Like, this team is pretty known, like I think Zamrock used this in like SPL like a few months ago, and it seems like pretty much the same team. I don't think there's anything changed. It's just the NJMP Webs team, yeah. Like NJMP Webs has like 4 or 5 versions, I think. So Zard, if it's I think this Mimikyu is Jolly if I recall correctly, but I don't think it's gonna be able to kill the Zard, especially because the Life Orb got knocked off. Saying this was Zamrock said this was over from turn 1. It's bulky. Is it bulky Zardex? Or is it just Willow's Zardex? But yeah, like, I kind of thought he was Zardex because he went out into this on Mimikyu, and like, Zardex gets a defense boost. This Mimikyu doesn't do anything to this. I don't think it's gonna be Willow's Dragon Dance, but this is odd. I haven't seen Wizard in forever. Flurbits is this. So yeah, he's still running speed on his Zard, so he was a fast Will-O-Wisp set. Yeah, he's fast for sure, like he outsped the Mimikyu and Whispered first. I should have realized when he Whispered first that it's fast. But he disconnects again. I think frustration. I'm just going off this Zard being max speed. So I think frustration might be a roll. Wait, that does absolutely nothing. But it's regular Pinsir, let's go to Mega Pinsir. But okay, it kills if it's, yeah, if it's the standard Zard set. Wait, that did nothing. Wait, what the fuck? That did zero. So I think he's like, is he like max speed, max HP Zard or something? So he's gonna Z convert here. But Scarf Jump put KO'd it, so yeah, this game is over. The Thorn played well. And I don't know, it's like he just outplayed the Smeagol. Like, he going for the Taunt, I wanna think. The Magic Code was kinda obvious, so I understand why X-Ray didn't go for Magic Code. X-Ray just, the Thorn just got the plays correct. Man. And when I record, it always seems like Team Germany loses. Oh yeah, yesterday I recorded Obliviate versus Prashpran, and Obliviate won. That was an interesting game. Outlet's just O course. I don't think the crit matters, because Scarf Jump still outspeeds this after the conversion, right? I fucked it up really hard. I mean, he just got the 50-50s correct with the Tornadus, and But it's the Smeagol. And yeah, also not suckering with the bishop was weird. That was really weird. What else? Like, I think Zemrock said in the chat that... Yeah, exactly. Zemrock, he needed sticky webs to... Like, if he got a Z conversion up with sticky webs, then he would outspeed Scarf Jump, right? So I assume he probably had Ice Beam on that. Like, they either run... They run Z conversion, right? I mean, Z Ghost conversion is what I meant to say. They run Ghost, right? But it is someone played that well, he deserves the win. Let me actually pause it real quick and check the score. Oh yeah, I was talking about that Obliviate game from yesterday, right? So basically what happened, I only missed 6 turns of that game, but then I realized after my recording that I basically wasn't recording my voice or something. Like, something was messed up in that recording, I don't remember what exactly was. And I decided against re-narrating it because, like I said in a few of my other videos, if I focus on re-narrating games, I will miss some of the live games and the time that I re-narrate games. So I'd rather set the focus on getting the games alive, is basically what I'm trying to say. I think that Ray Scarface is playing later today, so I'm looking forward to that. And there's another Asia game which should be in like 2 or 3 hours. I think Germany is still positive. X3 won earlier and someone else won. Yeah, Germany was 11-8. I think they're 11-9 now. But look at Italy, they're 13-4, they're doing so well. But yeah, Europe was not doing too well, but they should be 6-5 after the Thorns win. Not sure if this is up to date. Actually, it's not up to date, yeah, because ABL played earlier and that wasn't updated in the spreadsheet there. That game was a bit weird, but like... Man, like, I wanted to see X-Ray win, basically, is what I'm trying to say. But X-Ray, the Thorn played that well for sure. And I'll see you later with, like... Who's Asia playing against? My man BTB told me, but I forgot. But I see you later, thanks for the support. We are like 911 subscribers, something like that. And thank you for watching, and Dockridge signing out.